Hi guys! Welcome to my channel. So for today's video is going to be another vlog. Yes guys! And today is the day yung surgery date ko na minention ko sa inyo previously. And it feels like sobrang bilis nun guys. Kasi parang kaba-vlog ko lang na shinare ko sa inyo yung story about it. And today is the day. It's finally happening. So sobrang mixed emotions ako right now. Medyo kinakabahan ako. Medyo ninenervous ako guys. And also excited din at the same time. But one thing I know for sure is after this surgery, it will change my life. Yes, guys. Kasi I've been wearing glasses for the past 26 years. I think all my life, I'll say all my life, I was age of 5 nung nagsalamin ako. And I need to wear glasses or rely to my glasses to be able to see completely. And after this surgery, I won't need it anymore. And yes, so like I said, mixed emotions. And I feel like so far, this has been the biggest decision I've ever made in my life to go through that surgery. Kasi guys, ano, nerviosa talaga ako sa ganyan. Natatakot talaga ako. I pray that this surgery will go well. I prayed actually last night and I'm still praying guys right now na maging okay. As I said, talaga nerviosa ako pero nagpapaka-positive ako right now. So, ayun. And ayoko ma-overwhelmed yung isip ko ng sobrang daming negative thoughts and mga worries and fears. I'd rather be positive right now and pray for the best, hope for the best, and everything will be fine. So, I guess I'll see you in the next couple of hours, guys. And yes, let's go.
Bye!
Okay, guys. So, nandito na ako. And, pasok na tayo. Medyo maaga na naman tayo sa ating appointment. But, yes, let's go. Okay, guys. So, nandito na ako. And, medyo napaaga tayo. And, yes. So, antay na lang natin, guys. Waiting na lang. So guys, ayan na, getting ready na ako na. Papasok na tayo dun sa room na yan. And this is it guys. I don't think na pwede ako mag-video dun sa loob. Pero kwento ko sa inyo lahat to guys later. So ayun guys, let's go. Hi guys, so I am back and nandito na ako sa bahay. It's been actually a while. Hindi na ako nakapag-update kaganina. And this is just gonna be a quick update. So, nandito ako sa room and madilim siya, guys. Kasi hindi comfortable or I find it a bit hard to see pagka maliwanag siya. And I have been wearing sunglasses, yes, guys, even inside the house. For now, I will tell you the whole story tomorrow pag medyo a lot better na ako. But I am a lot better now in comparison to kanina. So again, I will tell you the whole story tomorrow. Pero yung quick update lang right now is I'm okay na guys. I can keep my eyes open and nakakita na rin ako. Maliwanag naman na siya straight away after the surgery. Pero it was hard to keep my eyes open then. For now, I'm taking a lot of rest. And I have the drops, like the medication that comes with it. I will go through that with you tomorrow, guys. I think yung last time na clip ko is papasok ako dun sa surgery and then nag-stop na dun, guys. It was really, really an experience for me. But, yes. And, so, I'll see you guys tomorrow. And I will sit down with you and share with you guys the full story of my surgery today. And, yes, guys. Bye for now. See you tomorrow. Hi guys! So, I am back and I am finally home. Kababalik ko lang from my first check-up sa eyes ko. And yes, so far so good. Everything went really, really well. So, I am here to share my LASIK surgery experience with you guys. As I have said last night na isi-share ko sa inyo, yes, I didn't had any chance na mag-ask kung pwede bang mag-film yesterday. dahil sobrang taas ng emotion ko kahapon, guys. Mas nangibabaw yung kaba, yung takot, yung nervyos, lahat ng mga negative emotions, I think, talaga nandun. And hindi ko siya makontrol. Kaya, it took most of my energy para i-fight yung ganong mga thoughts. And I think this is one of the biggest decision I've made so far in my life na mag-go through this. Ang daming consent form na kailangan pirmahan, ang daming mga paliwanag and everything na kailangan mo malaman, you have to understood before you go ahead with the surgery. So, I was there for like 2 to 3 hours na pumipirma ng mga papers and stuff and nagbabasa. Ayun na guys, dun na tayo nilaman ng maraming hindi magagandang emotion, sobra. Kasi, andun yung risk, we have to remember na everything can be a risk naman. Every surgery has a risk. You know, walang laging 100% assurance or guaranteed na it's going to be successful. So, that's yun yung pinaka nag-highlight sa akin na sa mga binabasa ko kahapon dun sa mga consent and that. And, yes, kaya talagang very, very high ang ating emotion. Very, very high. So I end up na magdasal na lang, magdasal throughout, and yes, na i-calm down yung sarili ko rin at the same time. It didn't help the fact that I was on my own as well. I was alone because due to the current situation, na pandemic pa rin tayo here, limited lang yung mga tao na pwedeng pumasok dun sa clinic. But luckily and thankfully na napaka-professional ng mga tao doon. Yung surgeon ko, grabe, sobrang galing niya, sobrang bait, sobrang helpful, and also yung mga ibang staff na nandun din. So, nung dinala na ako dun sa laser room, na ako na yung next, ayun na guys, talagang wow, nag-burst na yung mga emotions and that. And I remember I was lying down, andyan na yung machine, papunta na sa akin, and mag-i-start na, talagang panay, inhale, exhale, na kinakausap ko yung sarili ko, kalma ka lang, Steph, kalma ka lang, it's going to be okay, it's going to be okay. And, yes, so, the procedure itself didn't took long. I think it was approximately about 15-20 minutes, maximum 30 minutes yung procedure itself, or else like 20 minutes. Ganun lang siya kabilis, guys. Sobrang bilis lang, and tapos na, and pwede ka nang umuwi. After dun sa laser room ko, dinala ko sa another room para i-check uli ng doctor if okay ba lahat and that. And sabi niya that he's very happy and it was good. So, madami rin nag-ask sa akin sa messages ko, if masakit ba? Masakit ba yung procedure and that? Actually, walang pain. It was more of a discomfort than pain. Kasi it wasn't painful, pero uncomfortable siya. Like, yung mga pressure na nararamdaman mo yung pressure, and keep in mind, dilat ka, guys. So, nakikita mo siya, and then may episode doon na naging blur yung paningin ko, which is sinabi naman sa akin na mangyayari yon. It was very helpful na updated ka, na ini-inform ka sa mga mangyayari, kasi ganun yung surgeon ko. Nandito siya sa likod ko, and sa bawat gagawin niya, sasabihin niya sa akin, i-explain niya yung mangyayari and yung magiging effect noon. So, katulad nung may prenes na something sa eyes ko, and sinaction siya, and I felt the pressure, sinabi niya na makakaramdam ako ng ganong pressure, and magbo-blur yung paningin ko, and hindi naman siya magiging totally black, but it went sort of like that. Talagang medyo nagpanic ako, but then I remembered, oh, he said this, and then ni-repeat niya uli yun na ganun yun. Ito yung sinasabi ko, sabi niya na medyo blurry na ba? Sabi ko, yes. So, sabi niya, okay, that's okay. Okay lang yan. Yan yung sinasabi ko sa'yo kanina. So, yes. So, nakatulong yun sa akin. And, tuwing may gagawin siya, nagbibilang siya, 13 seconds left, you're doing fine. Okay, 10 more seconds, keep it up. Ganun. Tapos, 5 more seconds left, kasi kailangan mo talaga, guys, mag-focus. Mag-focus dun sa meron kang certain thing, like, to me, yung green light. Kailangan ko lang mag-focus dun sa green light and try not to move my eyes. So, nakaklump yung eyes ko na ganyan. Hindi ko naman nararamdaman na nagmumove siya. Basta, sa akin lang, kailangan tumingin lang ako dun sa green light na sinasabi niya. So, ayan. Anyways, napakabilis lang ng procedure. Umuwi ako. May mga medications na prescribe sa akin. Oh, ito mga eye drops. So, meron tayo dito ang antibiotics, merong anti-inflammation, and meron din tayo yung para sa pag nagda-dry yung eye. So, madami tayong drops here. So, ayan yung story ng surgery. And to be honest, napaka-straightforward lang niya. And ang mas nahirapan ako dun sa i-fight yung mga emotions ko na hindi maganda. Worst or pinaka-worst na part dun sa whole experience ko is yung after. Yes, guys. Ending after. So, hindi ako allowed mag-dry. So, hinatid lang ako and sinundo ako ng dad ko. So, inaantay ko siya dun sa labas and I've noticed I straight away wore my sunglasses. And I've noticed, hindi ko madilat, guys, yung mata ko. Pag dinidilat ko siya, pumipikit talaga siya. Na parang 2 seconds lang siya didilat. Tapos umiiyak ako na umiiyak. Hindi ko alam bakit siya nagiging ganun. And yes, so again, it was normal. They did said it. And yung pang fact na it's summertime here, na sobrang tirik nung araw yesterday. I finished at around 1 p.m. So talagang yung araw is right there, it didn't help at all. Sobrang sensitive niya sa light yung eyes mo after the surgery, as we know that already, guys, no? So even wearing the sunglasses didn't help at all. And I remember I cannot wait to go home. Tapos nararamdaman ko na medyo nagiging tight na siya. Andun na yung, ayan na uli yung discomfort feels and such. May binigay here na drops na pampaman head, but they strictly advise you to only take it when you need it. Because apparently, itong drops na to, if you tend to use it, it will slow the healing process. Pero nandyan yan for you to take. But they advise me to take paracetamol as well and then matulog. Usually, it helps daw. So, I took that advice. So, I took the paracetamol and then natulog ako. And then after that, guys, so from 1 till 5, 6 p.m., I was feeling a lot better na talaga nadidilat ko na yung eyes ko. And medyo nakababa na rin yung araw nun. I didn't need to wear my glasses much then or sit itong sunglasses. Kasi kahit dito sa loob ng bahay, naka-sunglasses ako kasi nga maliwanag and again, sensitive siya sa sobrang brightness. At around 6 p.m., medyo nakakagalaw-galaw na ako. Kasi nga nakakadilat na ako. And yes, as of now, talagang slowly it's getting better. Sinabi yata kanina, parang 12 weeks mo makikita yung full result niyan. So today, okay naman. Everything went well. Ano lang siya. Medyo namamaga pa. And which is normal. Pero in-increase lang yung dosage ng isa kong meds here or yung drops. In-increase lang siya from every 4 hours to every 2 hours. And I will have another check-up sa Monday. So, ayun yung gagawin natin. Pero for today's check-up, ang pinaka-concern is makita na if everything's okay and if pwede na ako mag-drive. So, yes naman guys, thankfully na everything went well and pwede na rin ako mag-drive. So, if you're going to ask me if is it worth it, the answer will be yes guys. Super worth it to for me. Pero if you are gonna ask me if I will do it again, the answer is no. Hindi, parang hindi ko na to uulitin kasi grabe yung experience ko siguro. Like I said, talo ko dun sa emotions ko. Yun lang, kung siguro mas malakas yung loob ko and if malakas yung loob nyo guys, wala kayong problema. Ganun. Ako kasi nasusobran yata sa kape ang tita nyo at talagang nagiging nerbyosa na. So, ayun lang guys. And yes, lalabas muna kami ngayon and gagawa ng mga errands and such. And I think that's pretty much it. And yeah, carry on with my medication. Meron namang mga emergency number na binigay sa akin if there is such queries or concerns na ma-experience ko. Meron akong number ng doctor any time of the day or night. Pwede ko siyang tawagan. Which is again, that's another helpful information. Kaya, ayun. And so, yung horrible part lang for me is yung first few hours, let's say, first 5-6 hours after the surgery, yun yung pinaka-worst. Yun yung dun mo ma-experience yung mga discomfortness and tightness feel and dryness ng eyes. Ayan. And also pala, quick lang din. So, nagbigay din sila ng shield. So, ito yung shield na nilalagay ko sa eyes ko pag natutulog ako. I have to keep this on at least for 7 nights. So, yes, I'm very, very happy. And thank you, God, for this successful operation. And I will definitely enjoy this new eye. It was an experience for me with this surgery, as I have said. Pero I'm glad that it's over and I'm glad I did it. And I'm very, very happy na to wake up this morning and I can see clearly. Talagang sobrang nakakapanibago yung guys. And yes, lastly, it's important to do your research dun sa clinic na pagpupuntahan nyo. Again, marami namang mga nag-o-offer ng this type of surgery, but I believe that it's important to do your own research about this and some others' experiences, kasi yun yung ginawa ko rin, and I know some few who went there to the same clinic that I've been to, and so okay naman yung results nila. I had it done for 10 years and 6 years and so far so good din naman. So yes, I think yun yung pinaka one of the important things to remember. If you're planning to go through this or any kind of surgery, do your research dun sa clinic and such. So yes, and I think wala na ako nakalimutang i-share. I think that's pretty much it talaga, guys. I hope that you find this video helpful and I hope na enjoy nyo rin. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I hope I'll see you guys again soon. Thank you. Bye!